reading from the Acts of the Apostles. We set sail from Troas, making a straight run for Samothrace, and on the next day to Neapolis, and there, from there to Philippi, a leading city in the district of Macedonia and a Roman colony. We spent some time in that city. On the Sabbath, we went outside the city gate along the river, where we thought there would be a place of prayer. We sat and spoke with the women who had gathered there. One of them, a woman named Dealer in Purple Cloth, from the city of Thyatira, a worshiper of God, listened. And the Lord opened her heart to pay attention to what Paul was saying. After she and her household had been baptized, she offered us an invitation. If you consider me to be a believer in the Lord, come and stay in my home. And she prevailed on us. The word of the Lord. The Lord takes delight in his people.
The Lord takes delight in his people.
Sing to the Lord a new song of praise in the assembly of the faithful. Let Israel be glad in their Maker. Let the children of Zion rejoice in their King.
The Lord takes
delight in his people. Let them praise his name in the festive dance. Let them sing praise to him with tremble and harp. For the Lord loves his people, and he adorns the lowly with victory. The Lord takes delight in his people. Let the faithful exult in glory. Let them sing for joy upon their couches. Let the high praises of God be in their throats. This is the glory of his faithful. Alleluia. The Lord takes delight in his people. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. The Spirit of the truth will testify to me, says the Lord, and you also will testify. Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "When the Advocate comes, whom I will send you from the Father, the Spirit of truth who proceeds from the Father, he will testify to me. And you also testify, because you have been with me from the beginning. I have told you this so that you may not fall away. They will expel you from the synagogues. In fact, the hour is coming when everyone who kills you will think he is offering worship to God. They will do this because they have not known either the Father or me. I have told you this so that when their hour comes, you may remember that I told you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
On the eve of his suffering and crucifixion, Jesus warns his disciples that they will also face rejection, persecution, and even death for following him and preaching his gospel. But the Holy Spirit, whom he will send, will be with them as their advocate, helper, defender, and comforter. And he will guide and strengthen them to testify to Jesus or bear witness to him against all adversities. You know, it is this Holy Spirit who makes faith come alive in the hearts and minds of people and all of us who are receptive to God's word. And this is exactly what we see in the Acts of the Apostles. All the activities of the apostles, the early part of the church, describing the Acts of the Apostles, establishing communities of faithful in different parts of the world. We have in today's account from the Acts, in the first reading, something remarkable happening. Paul, on his missionary journey, preaches about Jesus' gospel to a group of women in Philippi, in the district of Macedonia, and a Jewish woman, a wealthy businesswoman, Lydia, listens to Paul, and moved by the Spirit, allows herself to be transformed by Paul's words and witness. She seeks baptism for herself and her household. She opens her home to Paul and his companions and become a great supporter of the missionary efforts of Paul. This is the Holy Spirit working with and through the apostles to spread Jesus' kingdom. And all of us who have accepted Jesus and his gospel are called to continue the mission of the apostles, to testify to Jesus and his gospel, to be witnesses to Jesus and his gospel by our lives of love and service. And for this, we need to be always open to the Spirit at work in us. Then he will enable us to listen to God's word and be transformed by it, as Lydia did, and become missionaries for Jesus in our own home, in our own families, in our workplaces, by what we say and do.
Bishops, priests, and deacons, may they, like Paul, be fueled by the outpouring of the Holy Spirit as they preach the Word of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our world, may the Holy Spirit enliven the hearts of all believers and help us proclaim the good news of salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have lost their way, may God help them to hear his voice and follow his path. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those gathered here, may God give us perseverance as we continue on our own journeys of evangelization. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they experience the peace and joy of the heavenly kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering from the coronavirus and for the blessed repose of all who have died from this illness, as well as for the scientists and public health workers, that they may soon find a remedy for this global crisis. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions that have been submitted in our book of prayers on our website, and those we hold close in the silence of our own hearts. Let us pray.
for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all this holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exalted church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gift they bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to proclaim you, Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome.
Jesus stood in the midst of his disciples and said to them, "Peace be with you. Hallelujah." An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.